This is a place where I enjoy coming, and I have been fortunate enough to be here almost every year, every FOSSMeet for the last several years. So I won't trouble you too much. I will complete in 15 minutes. So let me start by telling you, sorry, but making a couple of corrections to what this person said in his welcome speech. First of all, being programmers and computer scientists, you should learn to be more precise. Like, there is nothing called 12 a.m. or 12 p.m. because you start counting from 12. So it is either 12 midnight or 12 noon. Okay. The other thing is that he said that I am an open source advocate. I am not an open source advocate, because you will understand. I thought you would know what is the difference between free software and open source. The difference is that free software is about freedom, and open source is about, you know, keeping the source code open. It doesn't talk about freedom. And we free software advocates believe that freedom is much more important than getting good software done. So that is a fundamental difference. And I don't subscribe to the open source. Of course, there isn't much difference in the software. Most of the software is licensed under GPL, and it can be called either open source or free software. And we choose to call it free software to emphasize the concept of freedom. And that's what I'm going to talk to you about today. Okay, so free software is about freedom. As Stallman says, the word free software is confusing because in English it could mean different things, like free of cost. And you know, we often say it is free as in freedom, not free as in free beer. In India, we have the advantage of having other words which fit the idea more precisely. The word Swatantra is what Stallman often uses, but he also sometimes says, you know, this is not Muft software, it is Mukta software. It gives the users freedom, and that is more important than how good the software is. Of course, all free software or open source is relatively much better than proprietary software. But then that is one aspect of free software, the freedom it gives the users. But now the problem is, you know, what the couple of things that I wanted to say. The first thing is about free and open source. Now, we call it free software because freedom is important for us. I think freedom is important for everybody, although you may not realize that. People realize that only when they lose their freedom. Like, even today, one of the lecturers here was telling me how he struggled with Microsoft Word when he wrote the thesis, because it was very difficult to do number of things there. Those who have used Word would know, you place a figure in a place, you take it to another machine, the figure would go somewhere else. Formatting all would change. That is only, and that is not the problem. The problem is that you can do nothing about it. You can complain to Microsoft, but they are not going to do anything. You can buy the next version. You can again pay and buy the next version. On the other hand, if it is free software, like in LibreOffice, you know, they will probably give you a bug fix. In fact, you often don't have to do that. Somebody would be doing all these things. So the software is often much more sturdy compared to proprietary software. But then again, you know, it becomes open source. You know, this open source concept, in some instances, that causes problems because it doesn't bother much about freedom. So that is one of the problems that we face. We have to speak more about freedom, more about free software. So that is one of the things that I wanted to say. The other thing is that just using free software doesn't mean that you get freedom or that you give freedom. What I am referring to is that, you know, one of the examples I always speak when I talk about free software is Google and, you know, service providers like Google, Gmail, all related, or Facebook. Now, these are names which are not very happily spoken about nowadays, because as Tolman says, we are not users of the software. We are used. We are used by them. We are not using the software because they harvest our data and sell it to other companies and compromise our privacy and lot of problems. So this is another problem. What is the solution? We already have some solutions in, for example, for Facebook, instead of Facebook, we have things like Diaspora, Friendica, and things like that, which are basically run by the community. Diaspora, I probably have some people here who are involved with maintaining Diaspora. So that is one of the solutions. But that is for a social networking, we can use Diaspora, Friendica, and things like that. But then we have other services which we don't have, for which we don't have community run things, just like email, which is probably much more important, email or Twitter or whatever. YouTube, I think there's something called PeerTube, which hasn't become very popular. But, you know, so the community is building these things, and that is what we have to do. In fact, I don't know whether you have heard about this. This is something I talk about in my longer version of my talk on free software. The concept of free software, the concept of community building things instead of buying from corporate bodies is being pursued by some people. And we already know that probably, we have this community built thing called Wikipedia has far overtaken corporate things like Britannica and other encyclopedias. So it is possible. We can build, as a community, we can build much more useful and, powerful things. So that is one direction in which you as programmers, computer scientists, you should strive in the future. Because the future, as we see, is not very... future is going to be a world of computers and robots. So you have a bright future career in front of you. That we shouldn't compromise our freedoms and our privacy for the sake of technology. This concept that technology is important for individuals from their privacy and the kind of issues is itself raised only by Stallman. In fact, Stallman who initially said that we need a free encyclopedia, and that was how Wikipedia was built. So what I would like you to think about is this. In fact, there are a couple of organizations, one called Oikonox. It's started by a German programmer. What they are thinking is how we can do, now we are building, community is building software in the form of free software and knowledge in the form of Wikipedia and certain other services. Can we do everything? Can community contribute everything like that? For example, you want chairs, tables, or microphones, or laptops. Can community build and give? What they say is that, there are people who love painting. So let them do painting. There are people who, you may be surprised, there are people in very high positions, like CEOs of companies who love to drive. They don't get to drive because the company thinks that they shouldn't be driving. They should sit in the back seat when a driver drives. But why don't you allow people who love to drive to drive? Then you get good drivers. I don't know how many of you joined this course because you like this subject. Very often that is not what happens. There's a lot of peer pressure and a lot of pressure from parents and teachers to choose a particular subject. Very often it is either medicine or engineering because they think that is the best for you. Is that the best way to do things? I don't think so. I think if you love to draw, if you love to sing, then you should pursue that. But that doesn't happen now. Why can't we build a society where people get to do, because we need all these things. We need chairs, we need tables, we need music, we need drawings and paintings. We need everything. And why don't we give these jobs to people who love doing it? Then, you know, if a person who loves to cook cooks food for you, it'll be very good food. But if somebody just cooks for you because he's paid to do that, then he will just manage to do something. That's what you can see. You see almost any kind of work nowadays, not just in India, almost any place. A carpenter does his job because he needs the money. So he just manages to do whatever he can in whatever way is easiest for him. So you don't get good products. You can see the kind of tables which were made 50 years back and what they make now. You can see the difference. So these are, I mean, this Oikonox is a group which thinks, why can't we build everything like we build free software? And there is another group based in Thailand, which is called Peer-to-Peer Foundation, which also is thinking along similar lines. I'm not saying that you should contribute to that, or we can expect that to happen soon. But what I'm trying to say is that these are the kind of things that came out of free software. So this is something that is probably going to change society to a great extent. So you people, apart from just contributing to code, of course, you have to do that because that is what you have studied and that is your profession. And probably you enjoy doing that. But if you have other loves, I think you must have seen that movie, what is that, Three Idiots, where a photographer was forced to join engineering and finally he found his talent and found the job that best suits him and becomes a good photographer. So like that, if you find what you can do best and what you enjoy doing best, that is what you should be doing. But maybe as a job to earn money, you have to do something else. But keep that apart. You do that as a job, but on the side, you do what you enjoy doing. You probably become very good at that, and that may become your money earner more than the other thing. So I hope you people will follow your passion. You should have passion in something. Okay, thank you.